The airfield I am standing on is the Funafuti Airfield, and it embodies the importance that Tuvalu had during the Second World War. Specifically, this airfield was built by the Seabees when the Americans came and occupied this island. See, right before the American occupation of this island, there was a battle, the Battle of the Coral Sea, where Japan lost enough troops so that they could not occupy the surrounding Tuvalu Islands. Through God's providence, that happened so that America could come in here and actually occupy and build both this airfield as well as a nearby hospital, which sadly doesn't exist anymore, and many different areas for troops to refuel, refit, sleep, eat, etc. Basically everything you need for your troops to go from coming across the Pacific to here to going and fighting the Japanese on neighboring Kiribati and other islands. See, this island of Funafuti and this airfield was used to send missions up to Kiribati, up to other islands, so that they could push the Japanese back. See, this strategy was called island hopping, and it was used throughout the South Pacific, and Tuvalu played an important role in that. However, if it wasn't for this airfield, America would not be able to have any of their operations by air out of this island, because it's the only airfield on this island, and it was built by the Seabees. See, what they did was they excavated the north part of the island as well as the nearby areas that are now lakes and now a landfill to actually create this airfield, to have enough land to actually build and produce this airfield on this coral atoll. But the airfield was not the only activity during World War II on this island. No, in fact, the lagoon also played a role. There were patrol boats carrying torpedoes throughout the lagoon. There were other naval ships throughout the lagoon. See, the lagoon meshed with the airfield was what made Funafuti so unique. You had an ability to actually send troops, send full missions that are fully outfitted to Kiribati, to other Japanese-occupied islands to knock them out, and you could refuel and refit here. But the last thing that we want to remember is specifically that the fuel was not kept on this island. See, Funafuti was being bombed during World War II, hence the reason that the actual citizens of Funafuti were moved to neighboring islands. So because it was being bombed, the Allied powers realized they couldn't keep the fuel on this island. So they put the fuel on a neighboring island and then brought it over here when they needed it. It was an incredibly ingenious plan. You had the harbor, you had the airfield, you had the fuel, and then you moved the citizens, the peaceful ones, somewhere that they couldn't get hurt. It was an excellent plan by the Allies, and plans like this throughout the South Pacific and throughout the island hopping campaigns led ultimately to the defeat of Japan and the victory by the Allied powers. That's what we can learn from the history here in Tuvalu.